Today's Power Query Challenge is all about extracting lists of dates for each product and organizing them into separate columns. It's actually pretty simple when you break it down step by step. Let me guide you through the thought process. We start with a straightforward task, grouping the data by product. Here is the logic. When you group by product, Power Query lets you combine all related rows for each product. Instead of summarizing values like sums or counts, we'll use the all rows operation. This keeps all the detailed rows in a neat nested table for each product. Here is the question. What do we actually need from this table? Just the date column. To get there, we add date in square brackets right after the underscore. This tells Power Query, from this table, just give me the list of dates. We then delete any extra code that's not relevant to our task. At this stage, each row in the all rows column now holds a clean list of dates associated with its product. Now we need to display these dates under separate columns for each product. A simple transpose won't work, because the lists are still nested. Instead, let's use the Table.FromColumns function. Here is how it works. The first argument is the list, our date. The second argument is the columns, the product names. By providing both, Power Query knows exactly how to structure the data. Each product becomes a column, its dates are stacked neatly underneath. Let's reflect on why this method works so well. Grouping with all rows gives the maximum flexibility. You can decide what to extract later. Extracting the date column simplifies the data, leaving only what we care about, and using table from columns directly creates the structure we want without needing extra steps. And there you have it, a clean transformation in just a few logical steps. The key takeaway here is to let Power Query built-in tools do most of the heavy lifting. Give these techniques a try. See ya!